And O'Neill gets a couple of steps behind Fernandez, and that was all he needed. Barth with the extra point to put Arizona State back within 10 here in the opening 2.5 minutes of the third quarter. And it's right down the middle. So as we have mentioned on several occasions, we have seen some barn burners and some track meets here at Stanford Stadium, and we've got another one tonight.
And that's exactly what ASU needed to do. Come out strong in the second half. Show Stanford that they're not going to just lay down and let them run all over them. College, sometimes it's lopsided the other way, and you're still winning. So it's not the telltale sign in college football today.
Wells up the sideline, 20, 30, 40, and out of bounds as they just continue to run up and down this field, north and south. Alfred Williams makes the stop. O'Neill now with 6 catches, 142 yards, and a touchdown. And Cron with 2 touchdown passes tonight, and Stanford at its own 41 with a short field here, Stoney.
They've had a short field a lot today, and they've really taken advantage of some of the field position they've had. It makes it a lot easier when you're not – I mean, both teams have done a good job with field position, and nobody's really been backed up in their own territory. And as a quarterback, you come out a lot more comfortable. You just you don't worry about taking a sack in the end zone. And when you have good field position, it makes it a short field, and you don't – you know, there are a lot of things that you could do with as an offensive coordinator.
Fasani to Powell, who's thrown out of bounds on the far side by Emmanuel Franklin. Fasani is 13 of 25 for 260 yards and a couple of touchdowns tonight, as both of these quarterbacks are putting on a show.
They've ran this a couple of times today, just a one-step quick throw it out there, let the receiver make something happen.
Powell also over 100 yards in receptions tonight, 6 catches for 143. Fasani looking at Arizona State from the shotgun right now. And calling the play from 5 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Here comes the blitz. Fasani going deep and overthrows Teo Johnson, the intended receiver.
Third down.
That
time Fasani just recognized that ASU was about to bring a blitz, got into a protection that could pick up everybody. So you'll see nobody coming free. The running back picks up the safety. There was a little pressure, but that was just because somebody in the offensive line missed a block. Tried to throw a little corner route. That's actually an audible you'll see a lot of times in the NFL. It's called a scissors route. The outside guy runs a post. The inside guy runs a corner route. They try to rub each other off.
Now they empty the backfield behind Fasani on this 3rd down and 5. Arizona State, here's the quick pitch to Johnson, and Johnson drops it again, and that's close to being a lateral pass, but the officials rule it a forward pass, and Alfred Williams up to lay a lick on Teo Johnson after the ball goes by. And Arizona State, they struck early, and they're going to get a chance to strike again. Taplin will wait for Eric Johnson's punt. Sun Devils have seen about 20 points turned around in this ball game by virtue of a fumble on an apparent touchdown and the ensuing 7 points from Stanford on the following drive, and then the roughing the punter call, which resulted in another Stanford touchdown. Taplin from inside the 10 starts at his 5, running to his right, and loses his footing, and then has Fernandez run up his back and knock him down before he can get back to the 20.
Here you see R.J. Oliver covering Ryan Fernandez on the punt. He does a good job staying in front of him until right there about the 25-yard line, but he keeps fighting.
And as we get back to action, Frank Maddox gets sandwiched out around the 30-yard line by Simba Hodari and friends. Cron right on the numbers with that pass, but Maddox can't hold on, and it's 2nd down and 10.
I think if ASU has a weakness on offense, it's probably their tight end, just because they lost the great one, Todd Heap, from a year ago. He was actually a junior. He could have helped this Sun Devil team a lot if he had stayed in school.
Solomon Bates on the sideline right there. As you see, his defensive unit did the job getting the ball back for the offense. 2nd down and 10 from the 12. Delvon Flowers, nowhere to go. Matt Fredericks was right there. They were not crossed up by that counterplay, or I heard Keith Jackson call it a crossbuck today. I saw UCLA run that play two or three times today. And that's an old term from football back when they played with leather helmets, which I remember. And it's third down and nine. ASU not good on third downs tonight, one out of eight. Cron has gone all the way at quarterback, though shaken up briefly in the second period. Looks left a long time, now runs right and out of bounds, shy of the stick around the 20. And Coy Wire made him pay for that one.
He did. He came up from the linebacker position, just rocked Cron a little bit. That time they caught him in a good coverage, actually, for Cron to run. It was cover two with a man type concept as well, and Coy Wire was able to come up and make the hit and stop that first down.
Yeah, and look at how far across the field he came. He came all the way from the right hash mark to run Cron down. Well, the riverboat gambler, Dirk Cutter, doesn't roll the dice on this one. Fourth down and three, and Nick Murphy is going to punt. Luke Powell at the 40. But the only thing we haven't had tonight is somebody run one back for a touchdown. A lot of air under this one. And a fair catch. We won't have one run back here either. Stanford at its 42-yard line now with a 10-point lead. And a nice little run inside right there up the middle by Brian Allen. I tell you, this guy has shown us something in his ability to run inside, and a powerful runner out of Ontario, 5'10", 200 pounds, and he can lower the blade a little bit.
Low center of gravity, just keeps churning those legs, running right through it.
Stanford has run 24 running plays and 20 passing plays up to that time. Now it's 25 and 20. Arizona State, 16 rushes and 28 pass plays. Second and five. This is Casey Moore, and he's got the first down to the 45-yard line. Lost his footing. He's also a load, 6'2", 240, and a senior. And I don't know whether you'd call it a low center of gravity or whether he's just a bulldozer. He'll knock you down.
Arizona State continued to put the pressure on. They blitzed the safety that last play, and the last two times they blitzed, they just caught Stanford in a run, and you know, they're hoping that they're going to throw the ball and get a sack on the quarterback, and it just didn't work out that way for them.
Jamian McCallum is a wide receiver out to the left now. He's not even listed on the depth chart. The pass near side for Johnson, and he can't hold on. And I tell you, that's nice defense right there by R.J. Oliver.
That was a great job. He, you know, it was one-on-one coverage, just a basic go route.
There's a penalty flag against Stanford back at the midfield stripe, and that's Luke Powell, not Teo Johnson. But Oliver does a nice job there, doesn't he?
Fighting for the football. It's a good job. He's pretty quick. He looked like he was just running easily with the receiver.
The ball will be moved back 10 yards.
On the offense, 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
And just under 10 minutes to play in the third quarter. Stanford with 64 yards in penalties tonight. Here comes Allen. There goes Allen inside the 40 with Willie Daniel riding him for about the last 6 yards. 15 yards on the carry for Allen, and they turn a first and long into a second and short.
Gain of 15 yards. Second down and five on the Arizona State 40.
Nice blocking up front. Arizona State's Willie Daniel, the man who made the tackle, is the injured player. And Allen is close to the 100-yard mark in rushing now. 10 carries and 80 yards. And those big guys up front like Zach Quaccia that you just saw bend over the football right there certainly help. Kerry Carter, the man in motion. Fasani throws. Carter had it and then gets hit and goes out of bounds. Ricardo Stewart.
Not a smart play.
Shoves him out of bounds and flags fly. Fasani play action, down the middle for the tight end. Touchdown, Stanford. Brett Pierce, his second catch, his first touchdown of the year and his career. And The last time Arizona State got a 15-yard penalty, it took Stanford two plays to score. This time it takes them one.
I tell you what, penalties will really kill you. And this is one of those plays that Ricardo Stewart on the last play has the penalty. They pull him out to yell at him. He's normally the free safety. All of a sudden he's not in there. They run the tight end right up the middle where the free safety normally was. They play in a different coverage. Just man-to-man coverage, no free safety. Solomon Bates gets beat. Touchdown.
Excellent point. You can't stop anybody when you're on the sideline getting your tail chewed by a coach. Caselli's extra point is good. The Cardinal goes 58 yards in six plays in a minute and 52 seconds to go back on top by 16. And so far, that missed extra point hasn't been a factor with just under 9 minutes left to play here in the third quarter. And then a coach that's as offensive-minded as Tyrone Willingham is, it's just like on a turnover. Throw one in the end zone right away and make him pay for it quickly. And that's what they do.
Plenty of time. They can be patient. But this is an important drive for them right here.
Here comes Tom Pace, who fields it at the 10. And stays on his feet and drags folks with him out to about the 33. First to 10, Arizona State. That's Delvon Flowers in motion. One of these days, they're going to hand it to him when he goes by like that. This time, they throw it to him, and he's knocked down after a gain of four out to the 37. Nice open field tackle right there by Gary Cobb.
It was. That was a good they ran that play action a couple of times tonight, just fake like they're going to hand off to the receiver, and they're trying to get single coverage on the outside and get a wide receiver open. Just couldn't do it that time, so he had to dump it to his running back. Usually you have a progression. You throw it, you're looking downfield for your top two receivers, and if they're covered, you throw it off to your swing route, out to your dump off.
Pace is the running back. This time they do hand it off. That's Darrell Lightfoot, who cuts it back into the middle, crosses the 40, and gets to the 41. So we call that play one play too soon.
The play before they faked that, yeah. This time they came back and handed it off.
And he does a nice job of going back and cutting back to an open spot of the field because Stanford had that one stopped for no gain. And Lightfoot puts Arizona State down in a third down and short, where they, again, are one out of nine on third down conversion attempts tonight. Pace and Carney are the running backs behind Cron. Will he run the option here? Nope, he's going to give it to Pace, and Pace breaks a tackle and gets close to the first down, but from where they spot it here on the side of the field that we're on, it looks like he's about a half yard short, and Arizona State faces another fourth down call here. Here's Pace. Look at this effort. He almost gets it.
He almost did. Looked like the tight end just needed to hold his block a little bit longer, and he would have gotten it. It was a great second effort, though.
Sun Devils are two for two in fourth downs. Pace stopped, and he got the first down. He got the ball across the 43. Coy Wire makes the tackle. And from my vantage point, I think he got it. Wire takes the football away from him, but the officials rule Pace down.
It looks going to be short.
My goodness. I don't think they got a good spot.
I don't either. I have to see the replay, but it looked like he got across that line.
Of course, if his knee hits the ground before he stretches the ball out, then it's all for naught. But let's take another look right here. It looked to me like he got the ball across the 40 before the knee went down.
He might have fumbled before the knee went down.
Yeah. So Stanford now with an opportunity to blow this thing open. And Fasani's going to throw a screen. And this is Matt Wright. And Wright will take it out of bounds in front of the Arizona State bench at the 34. Jason Shivers, the free safety, to make the tackle.
That was actually just a little bootleg. The tight end blocks down on his defensive end and then releases him. Sonny, all he has to do is get the ball high enough over the defensive end. Good touch on that pass. I think that's been probably one of the knocks against Fasani is just his accuracy.
Well, he's okay tonight. Look at those numbers.
For his career, he's only around 50%, which in college, you'd like to be up around 60.
Devils are going to blitz. Here goes Carter, foot race to the corner, 25, 20, and first down yardage at the 18. Oliver finally grabs a hold of him and hangs on with help from Michael Holloway. Just about the time Arizona State comes after the quarterback thinking he's going to pass, Stanford crosses him up and runs it well.
Just bobbled everybody up in the middle. I think that was Suggs that came down, sucked down a little bit too far, let the running back bounce around him.
Shivers wasn't able to pull him down for about a five-yard ride there either. So Carter will remain in the ballgame at running back. Moore will now line up as the single setback. At the 18, first and 10. They're going to the big guys again. Once again, this is Matt Wright. Wrestles for yardage inside the 10.
Stanford's doing a great job of just mixing up the short passes, taking a shot every once in a while, having some good runs. Really throwing ASU off balance on defense.
Well, not only that, but when you're getting those little cornerbacks out there and those safeties having to wrestle those tight ends, you can sure wear them out quickly, too.
It's without a doubt. That's just, you know, a quick drop. Throw it to your tight end that's posting up right there. It's just in this kind of offense, that's almost like a five-yard run. It's kind of what the offensive coordinator considers it.
Second and a yard. Here goes Allen. Loses his footing, but I think he got the first down.
They want to stay in this game.
Three wide receivers to the right. Allen is the running back. Johnson is the big target in the middle of the two little guys, and Allen's going to go right up the middle. And whoever it was that had trouble keeping his helmet on may have lost it, and it is Bates. His hat comes off. His penalty flags fly. And Solomon Bates is probably going to need to come out of the ballgame here for an equipment check because he's had a little trouble keeping that hat on his head. But let's find out what the flags are about. Stanford's backing up.
It could have been a face mask reason that helmet's on the ground.
On the offense. 3-yard penalty, previous spot, still first down.
Well, Bates just got hit right in the jaw by the tight end on a good block there. Brett Pierce just put his hat right up underneath Solomon Bates' face mask and knocked that thing right off his head. This is Wells in motion.
Here comes the blitz.
Here comes Fasani rolling that way. Going deep. Powell's too deep. The ball's out of the end zone. Two wides to the right of Fasani, one to the left. Carter is the running back. Fasani rolling right, directing traffic, now running, and knocked down as he gets to the 13-yard line. And they've still got to go 13 yards now to get a first down, and they can't get a first down before they score because it is a third down and goal to go. Well, they line up two wide receivers on the short side, then they send Powell in motion back to the left. They come to the short side for Johnson. Jump ball in the end zone. Touchdown, Stanford.
You didn't let me finish, except if you have a 6'7" wide receiver that can go up and catch the ball.
Teo Johnson's second touchdown of the season.
That one hurts.
Arizona State's in big trouble now.
That's just a complete mismatch. You got a wide receiver that plays basketball that can leap out of the gym against a small cornerback.
And Michael Holloway didn't look like he was 6 feet tall on that one, did he?
No. Regardless, that's 6 or 7 inches, and it's man-to-man coverage right there.
Buscelli's extra point, and it's a 44-20 Stanford lead. And I'll tell you what, the way this Cardinal team is putting points on the board, they may be the sleeper in the Pac-10.
I think they're a good football team. They're very solid. Got a lot of experience, a lot of guys coming back. It really helps you. It's a five-step drop, throw it up for grabs, have a lot of confidence in that big receiver. As a quarterback, you love plays like that. You don't have to think too much. You just have to drop back. As long as you get the coverage that you want, just throw it up there.
Tom Pace fields the kick at the 6, at the 20, and struggles forward to the 28. Stopped by Wire and Branch. Sean McDonald is the man in motion. Arizona State's going to run this one. And that is Mike Williams up the middle.
Your team's going to do well.
Well, Arizona State turned the ball over early in the ball game, and with as many passes have been flying around here tonight, it has been relatively a turnover-free game. Three wides to the right side of Cron. Going deep. McDonald right. at the 30, at the 20. He's going. He scores.
This will be a 16 or 18-point deficit.
Carney, the running back. Cron throws to the goal line, and it's good for two as the catch.
So they got a chance to win with three scores, two touchdowns and a field goal. How about that?
Ryan Denard makes the catch, and ASU's right back in it again. 2:57 left to play. Denard just goes down and camps on the goal line here.
Just posting up.
All you got to do is catch it. There's one you don't have to run after you catch. Barth kicks. Allen at the 2. Allen at the 20. At the 30. At the 40. At the 50. And I'm getting tired again, but Allen's not. He's out of bounds at the Arizona State 39-yard line. And the Arizona State offense is saying, hey, guys, we were only out there for two plays. Let's make sure that Stanford doesn't get us back out there two plays later. Look at this run.
Nobody's tackling.
Nobody's getting close enough to him to tackle right there.
That's true.
Wow, what a run.
I'll tell you what, Arizona State's going to go back this week, and they're going to evaluate their special teams. They take a lot of pride in their special teams, and they're just not getting it done today.
Chris Lewis is the new quarterback for Stanford. Kerry Carter runs head-on into Solomon Bates and others after a gain of about two.
That's a good day. I think they're probably just wanting to get
Carter again. Nothing there. A yard, if that, to the 36. And Lewis is going to get a chance to put his first one up right here, I would think, as Solomon Bates again makes the stop, and we have less than 2 minutes to play in a wild third quarter that has seen four more scores.
I think they want to get Chris Lewis some playing time. I think they've done this pretty much every game. They just try to throw him in there and get him a little playing time, just change the pace. That's part of the game plan, what Stanford really likes to do.
Stanford is a 40% third down team, 4 of 10. Two wide receivers to the right of Lewis to throw his first one. Does, deep, and over the head of Powell. Incomplete. Well, this is an interesting call now for Tyrone Willingham here, Stoney, because you can either go for it here and run the risk of turning the ball over to Arizona State, or you can punt and try to pin them back deep. But the way special teams have been playing here tonight, you might get one run back on you.
I think they're going to play safe and try to punt it away, pin them inside the 10-yard line.
McDonald stands inside the 10. Johnson has not punted in the second half, if memory serves me correctly. Doesn't get much air under it. McDonald drops it. Oh, my. But I believe he got it back. Cron with the ball at his 17 and a minute and 8 seconds to play in the third. Back to throw. Going deep again. In the middle. That ball is picked off, and Stanford gets it right back. Give that one to Tank Williams.
That's
and just like
throw.
That, Arizona State turns it over. Tank Williams' fifth career interception, Stoney.
Tank Williams is a really good player. He's going to be one of the top safeties this year in the draft. That's one of those plays that, you know, it's late in the game. You know you're down. You're just trying to make something happen, and you just force a turnover. Sometimes you just try to make a little bit more out of something. That's definitely a mismatch, tied in against the safety like Tank Williams.
Williams did a nice job getting up in the air on that ball, too. That ball wasn't that poorly thrown, but Williams was very, very close to the receiver. So Fasani comes back in after Lewis gets his three snaps, and he has it first and 10 at the Arizona State 47. Blitz coming. Here goes Allen trying to get around the corner. 30, 20, 10, 5. He scores.
Tell you what, ASU's not doing a good job of containing on those bounces by the running backs. And they keep running toward Terrell Suggs' side. He got pinned in a little bit by the left tackle. Running back was able to bounce around him and go in for the touchdown. There's nobody else out there.
Get a chance to see Brian Allen. I tell you, once he gets over on that sideline, it's like magic. When he turns upfield, it's over.
Well, he did a really good job of pressing the hole. He wanted to go inside if he could. He pressed the hole. That brought Terrell Suggs in, and then he bounced it around him. It's a mark of a good running back when you can press the hole until the last second and then pop around.
Brian Allen, that is not his longest run from scrimmage, by the way. His longest is 71 yards coming last year. But one person gets a hand on him at the 10-yard line. And that was it. Wow. I thought we were going to see some points put up, but I didn't think we were going to see 79 points scored in one football game before the end of the third quarter.
It's a shootout. These are fun games to play in, as long as you're on the winning side of that.
Yeah, I bet.
Gets a little frustrating if you're putting up 28 points on offense after three quarters and you're still down, 23.
Tonight is Baselli. And he drives that one all the way to the goal line. Williams comes out of the end zone with it. 20, 25, to the 30 and the 35, and finally wrestled down at the 36 by Simba Hodari.
It's a really tough position for a quarterback to be in.
Cron gets smoked as he throws that one.
That's what I'm talking about right there.
I tell you what, now Trey Freeman put a hit on Cron that he'll remember for a couple of weeks. And Tank Williams was a heartbeat away from an interception and six more points. Look at this hit. This one will rattle your chain. Ooh. Second down and 10.
Travis Scott just flat missed the defensive tackle.
Three wides to the right, and Cron's going to hand it off to Delvon Flowers and say, here, you let him hit you for a minute. That'll probably be the last play of the third quarter. Cron comes to the sideline. Well, he's hustling back to the huddle, so... And it's not going to do you any good to let the clock run out. You need to take one more snap here if you can.
Cutter's down there telling him to hurry up and get another play ran before the third quarter ends.
So the ball's on the 39, and it's third down and 7. And they do. They get it off before the third period comes to an end. Cron in trouble again, has to throw it away. That'll be the last play of the third quarter. So Stanford has pinned 51 big ones up on the scoreboard in three periods of play. They lead the Arizona State Sun Devils 51-28 at the end of three. All right, we got 15 minutes to play here at Stanford. The third period, by the way, ended on a penalty. Arizona State was called for an illegal shift. Stanford declined the penalty because the play resulted in Arizona State starting the fourth quarter with a fourth down. And you see the two head coaches, Tyrone Willingham, trying to get a jump start on the conference race. Dirk Cutter is about to go 0-1, or trying to avoid going 0-1 in the conference. And you look at these numbers. Bassani has tied his career high, which he set 2 weeks ago, with four touchdowns. Stanford has scored as well in the second half as they did in the first, and now starting to gain control of the time of possession. And we're not that far away from a 1,000-yard game here, Stoney Case.
He's had back-to-back career high touchdown passes. Yep. Four in the first game, four in this one.
Luke Powell awaits the punt from Nick Murphy, I should say, as we start the fourth quarter. The line of scrimmage is the Arizona State 39. Nice high one. Powell a fair catch at the 21.
Here comes a flag.
Arizona State got in the halo there. So Lewis comes back out to start the fourth quarter, and Brian Allen with 129 yards rushing, including that touchdown run of 47 yards, has set a career best for himself, and Kerry Carter will be the running back as we start the fourth period. And ASU still tough to run against inside.
Yeah, Stanford's really had the most success faking it up inside, where the running back actually presses the hole and bounces around the corner. And, you know, for what